In this tutorial, I will show you how to deploy the Nexus Hybrid Access Gateway. There are only a few steps you need to go through to finish the deployment, and you will know about the preconditions. And of course, when this is done, you will know everything you need to just go ahead and deploy the Nexus Hybrid Access Gateway in your own environment. So the first thing you need to do is to download the appliance files, and you need to select the right format for your platform. So if you run in Hyper-V, you download a zip file. If you run other virtualization platforms like VMware, or if you run Oracle VirtualBox on your desktop for testing the product, you download the OVA file, the Opal, following the Opal open virtualization format. And you should of course also download the digest files so that you can check that the download was correct. So I will first actually check the that the checksum is correct by entering this command on the OVA file, since I will use VirtualBox in this example. And now I should check that the same checksum is in the digest file as well. And it's correct. So now I verify that, that there were no errors when downloading the file. So next step to do is to go to your virtualization platform. As I said before, I will use VirtualBox in this example. And the process is similar in the other platforms. For production environments, you run with Hyper-V or you use VMware ESX. So then you will go to that console. But to run on your desktop, VirtualBox is perfect to use. So I go to the file menu after installing the VirtualBox software. I select to import appliance. And then I need to browse to the OVA file. And then I select to deploy the latest version, which today is 5.9.0. So I just double click this one. I select to continue and then just click import. So now I will just check my network settings so that I have a network enabled. In this case, I have a bridged adapter. I can change to a local network or a translated network in this case. And then I just start the appliance. And everything boots up. And once the appliance is started, you will need to log on. The user is called agadmin, the user defined by us, by Nexus. And first time you try to log on, you just enter this username. And the system will require you to set the root password because there is no default password. So now you need to set a secure password for the console. And you will need to enter it twice to confirm it. So once you set the root password or admin password, you proceed to configure the network. So I select one setup system in the console. I will check that my network settings are correct. In this case, I use DHCP since I got assigned addresses from my IT department. It might be that you need to manually enter the IP address and network mask and so on here. But I use DHCP, which is perfect in this case. So I just click Save. And then I'm done with all the basic settings. So now I can access the Hybrid Access Gateway by using the web-based administration interface. And the important thing here is that you enter HTTPS, and it should be port 8443, since that's the default port for the administration interface. Since we use built-in self-generated SSL certificate, you need to accept this the first time, and then of course you should replace this with a proper trusted SSL certificate. I select to log on. Here I can select to use the built-in demo license in the product, or you can just upload your own proper license that you've bought from Nexus or from your Nexus partner. So now I will need to set the root password for the administration interface. I use the same username as I have on the console, but of course not the same password. I click Next, and finally Finish Wizard. So now you know everything you need to deploy your Hybrid Access Gateway. You know how easy it is to set up and to configure your basic network parameters, adding administrative accounts and so on. So please go ahead, download your Hybrid Access Gateway and your license, and also take a moment to watch the other tutorials how to use your Hybrid Access Gateway.